Gentleman's game here. Look, guys, it's about to be November, so you know it's time for our annual NoFap November video. See, one of the simplest ways you can up your dating game is through refraining from watching porn and masturbating. I've made videos in the past on why this is and all the benefits that come with NoFap, so I'm not gonna expound on it too much here. Instead, this year, I'll be giving you some practical tips you can use to actually maintain your NoFap streak. Soon, you'll be walking down the street, laser-focused, with a profound sense of inner calmness and initiative, like you can and will accomplish anything. So let's jump right into it. So first easy tip is an obvious one, which is social accountability. Every year, I send a group text to a couple of my closest buddies. I tell them, it's time for NoFap November, boys. Who's in? And we'll make it a funny little challenge for all of us to maintain the streak for the entire month. If you relapsed and watched porn, you tell the group and have to pay for dinner. Honestly, you could have just lied, but it's all about maintaining your integrity to tell the truth if you do relapse. The most important part, however, was making the proclamation to your friends that you're going to abstain from porn and masturbation. See, humans are inherently social creatures. We care what people think of us, especially those from our tribe. By making your goals heard, especially to people that will check in on you to see if you're sticking to the plan, you make the consequences of relapsing much higher. You're not just letting yourself down, you're letting down your whole tribe. By leveraging accountability, getting to that coveted 30-day streak will be a breeze. Now, the second tip you have to use during this NoFap November is foresight preparation. And here's what I mean by this. Every guy who struggles with watching porn is, in some way or another, a victim to some type of trigger. Like, seriously, think back to the last time you fapped to porn. What was it that gave you that urge? Was it a certain image online or a video? Maybe just a feeling of boredom. What time of the day was it? The more you think about and track all these details about each relapse that you have, the more patterns that you'll be able to spot. Like, for example, you might realize that you have a tendency to watch porn and masturbate in the afternoon, like between 2 to 5 p.m. after lunch, when you're feeling especially bored. And normally, the thing that triggers you is the feeling of boredom after doing work all morning. And now that you know that, you can prepare for this exact future scenario. Like, if you know that the feeling of boredom is what triggers you to want to open up that porn site and start scrolling, then plan in advance to have another activity instead to distract you from your boredom. An example could be to go outside for a quick 5-minute walk or blasting your favorite song on the speakers. The plan is to have a default set of things you can do whenever you get that trigger, that urge, besides jerking off to porn. Let's say you know that you're easily triggered whenever you go on Instagram, since there are all these bikini models and whatnot that show up on your feed. Well, with that in mind, you can just make it a point to not use Instagram whenever you're alone in your room. You can instead allow yourself to browse Instagram when you're outside or in the same room as someone else, so that you won't be able to act on your trigger. This is just another example of having the foresight to know what triggers you and gives you that urge to watch porn, and then being able to prepare things to not give yourself a chance to act on your urges. Now, if you really want a perfect example of foresight preparation, you should check out Blocker X. It's an app that can help you quit porn and complete your NoFap journey to give you more confidence. Having a companion like BlockerX, a complete system, will help you get through NoFap November and beyond even that. Cause truth is, it's hard to quit porn when you're surrounded by people who think it's normal to watch it. The BlockerX community, on the other hand, will help you stay motivated. It has over 100,000 active members who are all trying to overcome porn and complete their NoFap journey. Now, the most common problem though with other blockers is that they can be uninstalled easily. With BlockerX though, you can't uninstall it, unless your buddy permits it. I strongly suggest BlockerX Premium for all the extra perks. Just click the link in the description box and enjoy 3 days free of BlockerX Premium. just enter my promo code GENTLE20 at checkout for 20% off your BloggerX premium purchase. And lastly, the third and final tip I have today for you guys is having open space. So I live with a roommate, and we're good enough friends to be able to talk openly about things like overcoming porn addiction. And so we actually have an agreement, an open door policy, if you will. Basically, we agree to keep our doors half open slash unlocked most of the time, so it's basically impossible for either of us to watch porn even if we wanted to. Now, if I bring a girl over or something, of course I'd lock my door. But generally, like whenever I'm doing work or just chilling on my laptop, I tend to keep this transparent, open space. And the temptation to watch porn rarely ever creeps in my mind. And even if it does, it's fairly easy to control. Now, I'm not saying you have to go around your house announcing that you're a porn addict, but if you don't live alone, like you're at home with your parents or some roommates, try keeping your door unlocked more often. Not all the way open to the point where you feel like you have no privacy, but just enough to dissuade you from opening up that Pornhub tab, cause it just feels weird with someone in the other room. I'm not saying you have to do this forever, just while you feel like porn addiction is a true problem for you. Once you get to a certain level, say like a 90-day streak without porn, then it just kind of automatically becomes your default state. You won't be racked with crazy urges all the time to fap, so choosing privacy over an open space is fine. But while you are struggling with getting a nofap streak going, especially during this month of November, I really think you should try to keep an open, transparent space. Do it for a week, and I bet you'll be able to pull off a 7-day streak. So those are three simple tactics that you can implement during this year's NoFap November, which again are number 1, social accountability, number 2, foresight preparation, and number 3, having open space. If you do all three with commitment, then you'll be able to last these next 30 days with ease. Best of luck, Kings, you got this. Let's get through the next 30 days together and make 2022 our year. That's it for the video. Make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more content like this, because I'll have more weekly heat on the way. Peace.